bedtime stories are not only for kids, they're definitely for adults. So sit back. Especially one in the city, is enough to drive almost anyone crazy. And so when they found out that there was a special retreat up in the mountains of upstate New York, you jumped at the chance to get away. That fire continues to burn as the flames continue to brighten the area. The unique smell of wood burning. What a wonderful smell. Fizzle out. dressed as a fire, told you a story, walked away from the campsite, back to the dining area, and there you saw her. Her name was Mary. You put a smile. The eye contact, there was some sort of electricity. Wow. You were more than 30 feet away. There was a connection. She was ahead of you at the door, going into the dining area. And she opened the door and waited for you. It seemed like an eternity that she was holding that door. You felt a little too proud to walk in after, or before her, rather. And yet, you wanted to show gratitude for the kind gesture of holding the door. And so you walk in. She walks in behind you. You both sit at the table furthest in the right corner. Would you like something to drink? You ask. No, she says. Do you mind if I get up and get a cup of coffee? I'll be right back. And she says, of course, take your time. Away from the table, but you realize that you want to make that coffee and you want to make it quick. That's exactly what you do. You come back, sit back down, you gaze into her eyes, she gazes into you. Things going in your life. So how are things going in your life? You ask. And she says, all speech. You know, the hustle and the bustle. If you want to eat, you can't sleep. And if you want to sleep, in the city. It's a dog-eat-dog world. You said, yeah, and unfortunately I do know exactly what you mean. When this is out of the rat race, you've pondered that, asked yourself that same question. you say, well, when do you ever play? When do you ever let your hair down? When do you ever open yourself up to other opportunities besides work? And Mary said, yeah. Everyone always asks me that, but I'll do that when I get older. Right now, I've got a plan, and I've got to keep working this plan so I can retire early. And I want to retire rich. I understand, you say. And then you told her the story about the fire. A season for dancing, a season for heat, a season for light, a season for frenzied activity, but at the same time, we cannot forget that life is short. Some more wood on the fire, Mary. Throw some more wood on that fire. At some point, the fire will go out. But as long as you got some wood to throw on the fire, off the coast. see you.